to stay right around 100, 101 throughout the rest of your work week. Then temperatures pop up just a bit for the weekend. Sunny skies all week. And you know, with all this sunshine that we get in Arizona, might as well take advantage of that solar energy. And in fact, 200 homes and businesses in the high country are going to be able to harness the sun's power for free. APS unveiled a pilot program yesterday to put solar panels on 200 homes in the Flagstaff area with no cost to the homeowners. The utility company will pay for the panels and the installation.
APS will own, maintain, and receive energy from the systems. And in exchange for their participation, eligible customers will receive a fixed solar electric rate for 20 years. Just think of that. No price increases for 20 years in that component of your power bill.
Now, the program could cost as much as $15 million. It's part of the utility's push to meet requirements to increase the amount of renewable energy it provides to customers. And if it goes well, that program might be expanded. But Scott Passmore, some people may not want to wait.
They absolutely may not want to wait because, you know, we have so much sun here anyway, so it makes good sense all the way around. But you can get tax credits now. And Rosie has more on that. I see the big 30% federal tax credit.
Absolutely.
Nothing wrong with that.
You know, I'm not covering any do-it-yourself project.
Right.
But what I'm doing today is I'm bringing y'all information of what we're getting flooded with requests for additional information. So hopefully this will help bring everybody up to speed. The solar industry is not the industry that we had back in the 70s and 80s. I'm probably the only one old enough here at the station to remember the solar tragedy of the 70s and 80s, where we had solar tax credits, everybody dove in, we had a lot of startup companies, we had, you know, things got put on roofs all over the place that broke, manufacturers went out of business, it was a mess. So what I want to do for you homeowners that want to get involved in solar, I want to just give you a little primer on how to do it right so we don't have that same kind of mess up that we have. With photovoltaic, which means I'm going to take sunlight and I'm going to convert it to electricity, I could even get to the point that I had a system on my house that would turn the electric meter backwards and start feeding electricity back to the utility companies. What you're going to have is, for a typical home, you're going to need about 6 kilowatts. Okay?
Okay.
Now this is 200 watts, so you're going to need about 30 of these.
Okay.
You need someone to get up there and take a look at the orientation, the shading factors, and all that, and the load on the house. That system, in round figures, is going to cost you about $48,000.
Okay.
Okay. But the tax credit or the utility company is going to give you $3 per watt.
Okay.
They're going to give you $18,000.
Okay.
Then you're going to get 30% of that net.
Okay.
So a system that retails at 48 is going to cost you 20 or a little less.
Well, not bad.
And, you know, now you're potentially 60 to 70% off the grid. So if you're motivated to go green, just know that 10 years ago, this system cost about $500,000.
Oh, really?
So we're going in the right direction. That's photovoltaic. The other area that we're seeing a lot of solar is hot water. And folks, I can tell you, with the tax credit, the utility company rebates and incentives, if you have to replace your hot water heater, consider going solar. It isn't going to cost you hardly any more to go solar than it is just to replace your water heater with a good first-rate Class A water heater. The last thing I want to note is, Robert, that panel you were showing earlier, is there were a lot of startup companies the last time this took off. We now have global corporations getting involved in this technology. I would advise you to buy large brand names and buy from people who have been in the business a long time. You can't throw this much money at an industry and not have troublesome upstarts get in the way and try and take advantage of it. So
let me just
proceed with caution.
That's great information. Real quick, you mentioned you're going to need about 30 of these on a typical house.
Yep.
Does that cover your bill completely? I mean, does that run your whole house?
It won't, Scott. It'll cover all your, it'll take all the peaks off.
Okay.
So if you're buying power right, it will greatly reduce, and in the winter, it'll probably completely eliminate your bill.
Really?
In the summer, you'll have some beep, 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 you have some little bills.
And they look a lot cooler than they used to.
They look a lot cooler than they used to. They're a lot lighter.
Yeah.
I mean, pick this thing's
no
15 pounds, you know?
No kidding.
So.
Well, Rosie, we appreciate that. Anybody likes some money back.
Let's do it right this time, because we sure did it wrong in the 70s and 80s. You don't remember that, do you?
I was alive. I just didn't get here until later. Where I lived, there wasn't much sunshine.
Kansas?
Yeah.
Nebraska?
Something like that. Yeah, Kansas, Missouri. All right, Rosie, thank you very much. Tara?
Yes.
There you go. The
photovoltaic.
I don't want to say ins and outs. Yeah, I'll never say that.
Thank you, too.
Photovoltaic.
Voltaic.
Photovoltaic.
Photovoltaic.
Volt.
Say that five times.